Greetings, it's naturopath Eric Backer from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of CanXida, the Candida dietary supplements. Thanks for tuning in. We're going to talk about probiotics today. In fact, I'll just talk a little bit about the brief history of probiotics, how they came about, how they started. If we look back really a long time ago, people always wanted to keep high quality foods for long periods of time. And one of those high quality foods was milk, whether it be camel's milk or sheep's milk or cow's milk or goat's milk or whatever kind of milk, you know, buffalo milk. People wanted to keep the milk. They wanted to store this sort of like, you know, this precious fluid. How could they keep it? And some people say that a long time ago, it happened by accident, in fact, when milk was stored in skins like bladders of different animals. And then this basically turned sour. So, you know, naturally some bacteria got in there, made it turn sour. And then these people found in the Middle East that they could keep, you know, this camel's milk, for example, or sheep's milk for long periods of time. It was sour. It wasn't really until 1908 that we had a guy called Eli Metchnikoff, who got a Nobel Prize, in fact, for discovering phagocytes or particular white blood cells. And Eli was quite interested to work out why some people lived to 100 years plus, you know, in the Balkans and in the Serbs and people in Bulgaria, for example, how they could live so long. And what he found was that all of these people had one thing in common. They ate yogurt, which they made. So yogurt is really preserved milk. And it's basically milk with the simple addition of some bacteria added to it. Today we use, you know, specialized techniques for creating yogurt, but you can easily make it at home in your own kitchen, not a problem at all. Basically, we just use some yogurt that's left over or some high-quality yogurt. We add it to cow's milk that's been heated up or sheep's milk, whatever you want to use, that's been heated up and then, you know, brought to room temperature, and then a portion of yogurt from the previous, you know, consumption's been added and left for 6 to 8 hours to inoculate. So what happens is basically the bacteria create lactase, an enzyme lactase, and that lactase starts hydrolyzing or attacking the sugar in the milk, the lactose. So it converts that really into a compound. It slightly curdles it. The pH gets lowered of this compound and yogurt is formed, what we now know as yogurt. So yogurt is used around the world by many cultures, have used yogurt now for a long, long, long time. Yogurt can be used by you, and it should be used by you regularly. You can read my article on yeastinfection.org on, you know, the many uses of yogurt and the many reasons why it is so beneficial for human health. It's an incredibly powerful food. It's a superfood, in fact. But we've gone beyond that now. Dr. Metchnikoff did a huge amount of research, but today now we know even more than Metchnikoff knew. We know now that we can make high-quality dietary supplements containing really top-quality strains of beneficial bacteria in amounts way, way larger than you'll ever get in yogurt. And also a convenience of just taking a capsule as opposed to, you know, having yogurt. I recommend you have both in your diet, that you have yogurt and you have a probiotic supplement. So the probiotics have been around a long time. Yogurt's been around a long time. Our knowledge of bacteria really has only really the last 50 to 80 years. We now know that bacteria, in fact, don't kill people. They actually are necessary for life. So many bacteria inside our digestive system do exactly that. They promote life. So probios for life, you know, as opposed to antibios, anti-life. So antibiotics kill life. Probiotics, obviously they provide life. So very important reason for you to take these every day into your diet and also as a dietary supplement for long periods of time to really help get that right. So there's some things up. These bacteria have been around since time immemorial for, you know, probably millions of years. But it's only really been the last, I'd say, less than 100 years that we understand the health-giving benefits of them. Make sure you take them in every day in your diet, particularly if you've got any kind of digestive problem, constipation, diarrhea, gas, bloating, whatever it is what you've got, try and take a small amount of naturally soured yogurt in every day. In the US alone, just in the last, I think, 10 years, the consumption's gone from 1 pound up to like 5 or 6 pounds of yogurt per capita in that period of time, as people are aware of the benefits of yogurt. I created a product called CanXida Restore, and I created it mainly as an adjunct or to supplement your diet. So it contains 7 of the best enzymes and 6 of the best probiotics together in a very specially formulated capsule. And it's going to be proven to be a very powerful supplement, just like the CanXida Remove was, the antifungal which I originally created. So check out CanXida.com with the X in it. And you can have more of a read-up on what CanXida Restore is all about. Are you eating yogurt every day? Have a think about it. It would benefit you immensely to eat a small amount of yogurt per day. If you can't tolerate yogurt, have a look at sauerkraut or kimchi, other kinds of foods also rich in lactic acid that can help to benefit your digestive system. Thanks for tuning in.